Very good afternoon to the jury members, chairpersons, and all the presenters present here on this online platform. I, Diksha Thakur, research scholar from Hashi Dayanand University, is going to present this e-poster on the topic problem associated with drug abuse, misuse, crime scene from a forensic perspective. And before discussing the problem associated with the crime scene, I would like to discuss what drug abuse or misuse mean. So if there is any act associated with the drug which is not in accordance with the NDPS Act 1985, or there is violation of the provisions which are mentioned in the Act for the purpose of recreation or to get high or for any other purpose than other than intended, that causes the drug abuse or misuse. So this problem of drug abuse is very much prevalent in our country, and apparently it is evident from the cases which are reported these days in the social media. But what does the scientific database elucidate about the pattern? So let's see, what does NCRB elucidate about the pattern of the abuse? So it is visualized, it can be graphically visualized that from this graph. For the year 2017, the number of incidences reported under NDPS Act were 63,800. Then for the year, it was 63,137. And there is a negligible decrease. But for the year 2019, the cases significantly hiked to 72,779. It means that the crime rate is increasing significantly. Now, coming to the problem encountered at the crime scene associated with the drug abuse or misuse, drug is a very significant physical evidence at the crime scene. But before coming to the problems, I would like to say all the problems which I have mentioned here, I have mentioned it after literature review, and few cases were received at Forensic Science Laboratory, Delhi, and some data I have collected from the social media as well. So first of all, the problem is there is evolved modus operandi. Now, with the passage of time, the offenders have find out different way, and their way of operation has been evolved. Number one is a human drug carrier. Now, the human themselves has become a way to facilitate illicit trafficking of drugs. And this was a case reported in FSL also, due to this process, they consume drug inside the body, and it is a very harmful process because it may burst and may cause the death of the individual. And after the death, during the autopsy, the drug was procured from the rectum and it was sent for the examination in the laboratory. Then second is drugs hidden in innocuous, harmless, or anti-private places. And recently it is evident from the social media that the people are they are hiding the drugs there in personal garments or in between the sleeves or during in between the collars, and they are easily able to move from one place to another without coming into the notice of the law enforcement agencies there. So this has become again a new way. Then third is addition of the fillers to camouflage the original drug making drug quantity, and that makes it very difficult to detect during examination. Now what happens here is a case was received in the laboratory, and the offenders, to reduce the quantity of the main drug, it was diacetyl morphine, it was the main drug, and to reduce its quantity, they have added enormous quantity of acetaminophen to it. Now, what problem it has caused for a forensic scientist during the examination was that during the preliminary examination, it was it created the main parent drug was unable to give result. It detected only the substance which was present in the large quantity. So these are the kind of problem the scientist faced during the examination if they did addition of fillers to this extent in enormous quantity. Then second is unawareness in the law enforcement agency to deal with the evolved crime scene. So the law enforcement agency, like the police officers or the reporting officers who report at the crime scene at first, they are not able to understand the evolved crime scene. This was also a case reported where a talc factory was running, and just in between, designer drugs were also manufactured there. Usually the drug diacetyl morphine like literature says that it ranges, its color ranges from light gray to brown gray, brown color, right? Okay. But in this case, the designer drug, they have, the process of manufacturing is evolved to an extent the drug was present in pink color. So in this way, the physical evidences of drug are overlooked because they're not able to differentiate between what is if it is really a talc powder or a designer drug is being manufactured there in this factory. So this is one of the biggest problem due to the awareness we face. Then third is the designer drugs are rapidly metabolized, rendering drug metabolites undetectable in routine testing. And the fact is that all the offenders are well aware of this process, that they get rapidly metabolized. So after having their pleasurable experiences, what they do, they drink a lot of water, they do exercises to get rid of the metabolites from their body. And due to this, the designer drugs, sometimes they are not detectable in the routine testing. So now coming to the conclusion, I would like to discuss some of the solution, probable solution to this problem. And the solutions are like through these problem need immediate need to address the problem through number one, awareness. Now awareness must be generated among the scientific communities, among the scientists and the researchers, because this is a problem which our country is facing right now, and we need to work over this problem. And second, awareness must be generated among the legislative, the law making agency, because this is a very common problem researchers fail when they have to pursue any topic on narcotic drug or psychotropic substances drug. They have to take permissions from the authorities, right? And it's a very stringent and a tedious process, and it consumes a lot of time. So I think legislative, in perspective of research, they must provide a flexible or a easy going policy so that the more and more number of students can pursue a research topic over these problems. Then the second solution is like we need to work over the development of sensitive analytical testing methods so that the detection is made possible. It should be the technique developed must be sensitive and must be efficient, must be able to detect the drug in small quantities. Then third is the development of database for novel substances abused. Now, what insight I have developed from the literature review is that if we see the data collected from the NCRB, it does talk about the Charas, Ganja and the other conventional drugs which are being abused. But when it comes to designer drugs, no particular data or database is available from this. But if we see social media, we read newspaper, a number of designer drugs cases are reported, but in particular, we do not have an official record through NCRB for this. So I feel that somewhere we need a more stringent data monitoring system so that database can be developed for these kind of substances. So at the end, I would like to mention the significance of this ePoster. It offers a different avenues for the researchers and the scientists over which they can work, they can do research. And we need to come together to curb this menace of drug abuse in our country. So that's all from my side. Thank you, everyone.